Good morning, student. Today we are going to complete the mechanism of cracking. In last class, we complete the method to overcome the demand of gasoline, in which we discuss three methods: cracking, synthetic petrol, and reforming. In last class, we completed the process cracking. Cracking is breaking off of higher hydrocarbons with the high boiling point into the low hydrocarbon with low boiling points. Now, the types of cracking. We discussed in last class types of cracking: thermal cracking and catalytic cracking. Thermal cracking, the cracking which is carried out in the presence of temperature, is called the thermal cracking. It is of two types: liquid phase thermal cracking, LPCT, and second is the vapor phase thermal cracking. The cracking which is carried out in the thermal vapor state is called the vapor phase thermal cracking, VPTC. We discussed this in last class. Catalytic cracking. What is the meaning of catalyst? Catalyst is a substance which used in very minute amount and which alter the rate of reaction. It may be increase the rate of reaction or it may be decrease the rate of reaction. If it increases the rate of reaction, it is called positive catalyst. If it decreases the rate of reaction, it is called negative catalyst. Here, catalytic cracking, the cracking which is carried out in the presence of catalyst is called the catalytic cracking. It is of two types: fixed bed catalytic cracking and moving bed catalytic cracking. We completed these old topics in last class. Today, we are going to complete the mechanism of cracking: thermal cracking and catalytic cracking. Today we discuss the methods of mechanism of cracking. First we go for the thermal cracking. Thermal cracking followed by the free radical mechanism. What is the meaning of this free radical? Free radical is the reaction intermediate. Free radical is a reaction intermediate which is formed by the homolytic fission of a bond which is formed by the two electrons when it is homolytic cleavages occur in between that bond. Each species is apart from the one electron. The species form is called the free radical. In this mechanism, three steps goes on: initiation, chain initiation, chain propagation, and chain termination. Now, one by one, first step is a chain initiation step. Chain initiation, we will take the example of nonane. Nonane, it is a 9-carbon straight chain hydrocarbon at the high temperature. After cracking, it produces two free radicals by the homolytic fission. At the carbon 4 and 5, it forms carbon 5 free radical. This is the electron which is present on after the elimination of the bond between both the carbons. This is a carbon 5 free radical and this is a carbon 4 free radical. Now, chain propagation, that means as the nonane molecules are available, this chain is propagated. Continuation mein chalti rehti hai. These free radicals undergo fission at the beta position and the reaction continue until a thermally stable radical is formed. First, the thermally stable free radical formed, and after that propagation goes on till the hydrocarbon chain is available. Now, the free radical, carbon 5 free radical, which is formed in the above steps, chain initiation mein jo bana tha, uska further elimination, usme se alkene ka elimination hota hai, aur carbon 3 ka free radical ban jata hai. Carbon 3 carbon ka jo free radical bana hai, wo further converted into carbon 1 methyl free radical after the elimination of another molecule of alkene, ethene. This free radical, this methyl 1 carbon free radical attack on this nonane chain, which is a parent hydrocarbon chain. When it attacks on the longer hydrocarbon chain, it forms methyl, obstruct the hydrogen from this nonane molecule and form methane. After forming methane, it forms another free radical. This is a free radical, another free radical which is formed with a long chain free radical. This free radical further converted into the one alkene is eliminated with the long chain. Alkene, carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 carbon chain of alkene is eliminated. Alkene is formed as well, 2 carbon free radical again form. This chain is goes on till the parent hydrocarbon chain or the heavy molecules, like the molecule which has to be cracked is available. This chain is propagated until all the molecules are cracked. Now the next step is a termination. In termination, all the free radicals which are initiator combine together and form a saturated chain, like methyl free radical combined with the methyl free radical. Both methyl free radical, one electron is with this methyl and one electron with this methyl, both combine form a single bond between them. This is a ethane molecule is formed. Same ethyl free radicals combine together and form the butane molecule. This is over about thermal cracking mechanism. It followed by three steps: chain initiation, chain propagation and chain termination. Now we are doing catalytic cracking, which is followed by carbocation mechanism. Carbocation mechanism, what is the meaning of this carbocation? It is also known as carbonium ion. The carbon which possesses positive charge on it is called the carbocation. Carbocation is an electron deficient species, जिसके पास में electron की कमी होती है, इसीलिए इसके ऊपर positive charge होता है. This thermal cracking gets it is assumed that catalytic cracking occurs through the carbonium ion or carbocation intermediate. The intermediate which is formed in this reaction is carbocation or carbonium ion. Alkene produced in thermal cracking gets protonated at the acidic sides of catalyst. Now this nonane molecule, again we are taking the example of same nonane molecule. This nonane molecule after cracking produces carbon 4 carbon butene alkene and carbon 5 alkane pentane. This carbon 4 alkene further in the presence of catalyst it produces proton, which proton attack on this double bond position. When it attack on double bond position, the hydrogen is attached with this carbon atom, and this double bond is break up. And after breaking this double bond, the positive charge is coming on that carbon because of electron deficiency. This carbon 4 carbocation, this is the secondary carbocation because it is attached with the two carbon atom. This secondary carbocation further attack to the new nonane chain. When it attacks to the new nonane chain, it forms another carbocation and obstruct the proton. This carbocation which is formed in above reaction obstruct the proton from this nonane molecule and forms CH3 CH2 CH2 CH3, that is a n-butane, and new another carbocation is formed here. This carbocation which is formed now is after beta cleavage or shifting of the bond forms the eliminate the alkene molecule and form the smaller carbocation. Here this bond is shifted here. When this bond is shifted here, CH2 CH2 CH3 here, CH2, the because of shifting of this bond, this carbon is electron deficient and positive charge coming on that carbon atom. It forms primary carbocation CH3 CH2 CH2, positive charge, and because of shifting of this double bond here, shifting of double bond yahan aa gaya, jiski wajah se hamare paas mein this alkene is formed as a byproduct. Now this primary carbocation further converted into the most stable secondary carbocation. Primary carbocation ke mukabale secondary carbocation jyada stable hota hai, isliye secondary carbocation ke andar after the shift of this hydrogen on the carbon 2 shifted to the carbon 1, and because of shifting of this hydrogen, this carbon is electron deficient and the positive charge is shifted from this carbon to this, and secondary carbocation is formed. Now same mechanism is followed by aromatic hydrocarbon chain. this aromatic hydrocarbon chain. When protonated in the presence of catalyst, it formed this sulfocation. This sulfocation further after elimination of benzene forms sulfocation, which is after elimination of proton. Proton, it forms alkene. This is a catalytic cracking. Today we discuss thermal cracking and catalytic cracking. Thank you.